clandestine.
Out of the air and from under the sea, these weird zombies from Mars swarm in to annihilate the Earth.
What are you?
I am Marix, a native of the planet Mars. Perhaps not quite a human being by earthly standards. The orbit of our planet Mars is so far from the sun that climatic and atmospheric conditions there are much inferior to those on Earth. We can construct an H-bomb which, when detonated at the correct time and position, will alter the rotation of a planet enough to change its orbit to any extent we desire.
You propose to move Mars into the same orbit as the Earth?
Exactly.
Their diabolical scheme seems sure of success until Larry Martin is called upon.
And so, Larry Martin, we direct you to use all means at your command to rid the Earth of these horrible zombies. We're informed that another of their rockets is now approaching Earth.
Is there time to intercept it with your rocket?
No, at the rate that ship is traveling, it'll be out of radar range before we can get off the ground.
Unless it lands.
Then ground defense will handle it, Bob. Unless Mr. Steele thinks we can help.
Yes, Larry, I do. It is the duty of my department to handle all matters menacing world security. And you're one of my executives. I realize that your work has usually been in the interplanetary zone. In this case, I think you ought to take charge, both on land and in the air.
Very well.
There he is. On target, steady as she goes. Firing ray gun.
Brings you weird adventure in 12 explosive, suspense-filled episodes. Zombies of the Stratosphere.
To intercept it with your rocket?
No, at the rate that ship is traveling, it'll be out of radar range before we can get off the ground.
Unless it lands.
Then ground defense will handle it, Bob. Unless Mr. Steele thinks we can help.
Yes, Larry, I do. It is the duty of my department to handle all matters menacing world security. And you're one of my executives. I realize that your work has usually been in the interplanetary zone. In this case, I think you ought to take charge, both on land and in the air.
Very well. I suppose the regular defense network has already been alerted.
Yes, they're standing by until we see what that ship's going to do.
Help me on with my flying suit, Bob. I may have to get into action in a hurry.
Prepare for a landing.
Radar screen as it was passing over the Morongo Hills.
It must have landed somewhere in those hills.
Probably. I'll fly out there and try to find it.
Good. You can get there quicker than the ground forces.
Oh.
They picked you up on radar. The whole country's looking for you.
That was to be expected. But if we transfer our cargo quickly, we can get away before they locate us. Help me with the boxes. Seems to be all. Take off at once.
Yes, sir.
Get in the back with Shane. Arab will take the truck to the cave and unload the supplies. Roth and I will be there later to help you as soon as we conclude our arrangements with Dr. Harding.
Yes, sir. Side door will take us right to his laboratory. Nobody will spot us.
Very well. What are you doing here?
I thought you were supposed to be delivering those plans.
Yeah, I know, but we got a better deal here.
What are you?
I am Marix, a native of the planet Mars. Perhaps not quite a human being by earthly standards. However, I can assure you that my people are much further advanced in intelligence and scientific achievements than you Earthmen.
Well, what are you doing here?
For some time, I've been in contact with your assistants, Roth and Shane, making arrangements for a project I'm undertaking here. I will need your technical assistance and the facilities of your laboratory.
And why do you think I'm going to help you?
Because I'm in a position to inform your government that you've been selling atomic secrets to an unfriendly foreign power. The results of such an exposure would be much more unpleasant for you than the alternative I'm allowing.
What is this project you're planning?
The orbit of our planet Mars is so far from the sun that climatic and atmospheric conditions there are much inferior to those on Earth. But in spite of these physical handicaps, my people have developed a means of correcting the situation.
You mean you can change the orbit of a planet?
Exactly. But of course, to accomplish that, we must first clear the orbit of Earth's interference. So my mission here is to plan an H-bomb explosion sufficiently strong to send Earth spinning out into space and leave room for my own planet.
That would mean the destruction of the world and everyone on it.
That need not concern you if you are safe with us on Mars, unless you would prefer to await the event in a federal penitentiary.
What would you expect me to do?
We will construct a hydrogen bomb in a well-concealed cave, which I've already selected. The critical materials and the necessary electronic equipment have already been brought down for Mars and are now stored at my island base in the Pacific. I'm moving them from there to the cave in my rocket ship.
Well, then why do you require my help?
Because we will need additional supplies, such as uranium, steel, and other structural materials. We will also require the use of this laboratory to assemble parts of the bomb.
Very well. What comes first?
I will give you a list of what is required. And while you're obtaining these items, I will go to the cave and get the basic construction started.
How long can you guys stay underwater?
Oh, half an hour, perhaps a little longer. The atmosphere on Mars is so thin, we've adapted ourselves to live on very little oxygen.
Is that the last of it?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now I have another assignment for you. Dr. Harding has learned that a freight shipment of uranium will be passing through this area today. A train, a local freight, will stop at Parala Junction about 2:15. You and Shane will take over there.
How many men will be on it?
I'm not sure, so you better make arrangements for additional help. Now, it won't be safe to stop to unload the uranium at the junction. Take the train out into the hills somewhere between the junction and Gomez Siding. Find a good hiding place for the uranium. We'll pick it up later with the truck.
Okay.
You wouldn't want to be caught with that map on you. Burn it.
I'll start lining things up.
Very well. I will be in the inner cave. You can report to me by radio.
Right.
That does it. You're all set to go.
But that truck may be miles away by now.
Not too far. The signal from that radio sending unit I planted on the truck is still coming in strong. All I have to do is fly down the beam. So far, so good. Let's see what the infrared light brings out.
Why, it's nothing but a railroad map.
Yes, with the section between Peralta Junction and Gomez Siding underlined.
Which means what?
It could mean something's going to happen there, so we better try to find out what. We've got a lot of country to cover, so we better split up the job. You two go to the junction, check on things there. I'll start at Gomez Siding and follow back up the line.
On top of that freight car?
Yes, when we got here, those men were stealing the train. Bob jumped on it and tried to stop them.
Any way to stop that train?
No, my key's out. They must have cut the wires after they slugged me.
There's a brake. Can you fix it?
I can fix it, but it'll take time.
Maybe I can catch them in a car.
Not much chance. The road only gets near the tracks in a few places.
Is that old tank working?
Yes, we just unloaded it for some farmer who's gonna make a tractor out of it.
Maybe I can cut across country and stop that train.
You'd better try. If it keeps going, you'll crash it through passing the train head on.
Fixed. By time we start and unload the stuff, isn't it? How'd that get on our trail?
I don't know, but they got on us somehow.
We're not gonna have much luck in loading a car of uranium with that thing chasing us.
Yeah, we better forget it. Make our getaway while we can.
Thank you.
too late. The passenger train's already going through the junction. Only one more chance now. If I can raise Gomez Siding, they can derail the freight there.
Too close for comfort. I wonder what it was all about.
I don't know. There must be something on that train they were planning to steal. We'll check with the railroad company and find out.
There is one more source of uranium, but it'll take time to make the necessary arrangements to get it.
And start them at once. We must have uranium for the primary reactor in our H-bomb. Everything must be ready by the time the Earth reaches this position, for that is the point at which the explosion of our hydrogen bomb will alter the Earth's rotation sufficiently to send it spinning out into space. Of course, we must have the work completed well before that date to allow time for our escape to Mars.
I'm not looking forward to this trip to Mars.
It won't be dangerous. and you'll only be there a short time. Our controlled explosions on Mars have already been set. As soon as the Earth's orbit is clear, we'll move Mars in to occupy it. Then we can enjoy the same atmosphere and climate on Mars that you now have here. Our immediate problem is to find a safe place to land the rocket load of electronic equipment that I have to bring in from my island base.
That carload of refined uranium was the only thing on the train of any unusual value.
That's probably what they're after. We still can't take any chances.
Larry Martin's office. Yes, he's here. It's for you, Mr. Steele.
Steele speaking. Yes? Yes. Very well. They just pick up an unidentified aircraft coming in again. They're still a long way off, and you may have a chance to intercept it.
I'll fly out the rocket and try it. If you intercept it, what do you do?
Try to follow him and find out where his base is.
All set?
Yes, sir. You got your orders.
Good.
Hiya, Larry. We're all set.
Good. Let's go. Ready?
Anytime.
Fire pilot jet.
Fire pilot jet.
Fire main jets.
Fire main jet.
Larry Martin calling Mr. Steele.
Come in, Larry. Where are you?
We've just taken off. Is that other ship still on radar?
We lost them behind the mountains back of Lake Emerald. They may have landed there. You better check on them.
Yes, sir.
Heading in course for Lake Emerald.
Get this unloaded as fast as you can. I have heard on the radio that there's another rocket searching for me.
Okay. We'll dump it all right here and move it down to the boat later.
A squadron under those trees. We'll just cruise around for a while and see if we can pick up something.
All right.
That's all. I'm taking off at once.
Okay.
Thank you.
There he is. They're just taking off.
Can we take after him?
Yes, but don't follow him too close. All we want to do is find out where he's going. We're gaining on him.
Good. Under control? Oh, just barely. Fuel pressure's dropping. Must have cracked a line.
We can't keep up with him now, and we can't maneuver to get a shot at him. Let's head back to the field.
Okay.
So now our next move is to try to find out what that rocket ship was doing up there in the lake.
You didn't see any sign of a truck this time, did you?
No. There were no roads near the place where it landed, but it was close to the lake. If they unloaded anything, it could be picked up by boat.
There are a lot of boats on that lake.
Yes, and we've got to check them all, so let's go. You two take one side of the lake, I'll take the other.
Right. That's a load.
Okay, take it away. We'll wait here till you get back.
Right.
Thank you.
Well, that's all we salvaged from the wreck of the speedboat.
What is it?
Well, it's part of an electronic device, but I've never seen one just like it before.
Neither have I. But it's certainly for some illegal project, or they wouldn't be smuggling it in by rocket ship.
That's a reasonable guess, but it still doesn't tell us just what it is.
No, but I think I know who can tell us. Dr. Harding.
Yes, he's done a lot of research in electronics, but he never seemed to be willing to work with anyone else.
I know he has a reputation for being very secretive, but I have the authority to demand his cooperation. Let's box this up and take it out to him.
Well, we have enough material here to keep going for a while. Fortunately, my island base can replace the parts that were lost.
How about getting it here? We'll be watching for the rocket from now on.
The country which was trying to buy my atomic power plant designs is still in the market. They would probably let us use one of their submarines if we were willing to give them the designs.
Why not? They'll never get a chance to use them. In a short while, we'll blast Earth off its orbit and send it spinning out into space so that our own planet Mars can take its place. All that matters now is to complete the H-bomb on time. How long would it take this sun-friendly ally to deliver our shipment?
Judging from my past dealings with them, their submarine could deliver the material in the harbor in a week.
Good. Then make the necessary arrangements at once. Roth, go to the harbor. Charter a suitable boat for 1 week from tonight.
Okay.
Calling X-71.
Go the man who picked up that stuff from the rocket. You going to arrest them?
After we find out where they're going.
Do for you?
We want to charter a boat. Just an open job, about 25 feet, but fast.
When do you want it?
1 week from tonight.
Well, I don't usually charter my small boats for night trips.
We won't be going out of the harbor. We won't need it for more than a couple hours.
Well, I'll show you what I've got.
You're under arrest. Search them, Bob. Those two before?
No, but I'd sure like to see them again.
Well, I'm afraid they won't be back here. But we do know they got business in harbor a week from tonight. And we'll be on hand to see what takes place.
Nothing in sight yet.
No, but we'd better keep looking.
It's about time that sub showed up, isn't it?
Yeah, but you won't see it.
Float the stuff up in buoys.
Off there.
There's another one behind us.
Hey, what's that boat doing?
They're picking up something out of the water.
Maybe we'd better check on it.
Hey, there's a boat heading this way. We won't have time to pick up that other buoy. Sink it!
I want that buoy. Stand by to pick it up. Let's get after that gang.
Stop him!
Fouled our prop, but good.
They're landing at that old cannery wharf. If we can clear that prop and get to my car in time, we can still catch them. Let's get to work. Drive over to the cannery wharf. If you see any sign of them, call me on the radio.
Calling Larry.
Come in, Bob.
They're heading north along Front Street in the black panel truck. Do you want me to follow them?
No, I'll take over now.
Okay.
Stop.
and stop.
Sign of the ship that dropped these buoys?
No, there was nothing else in sight. They may have been brought in by submarine.
It's possible. We'll alert all patrols to keep a constant watch on this area. We're obviously up against a very powerful enemy. We must prevent them from completing their project, whatever it is.
Yes, that's the big question. What are they trying to do?
Well, all these instruments and the one we picked up from the rocket shipment are all electronic apparatus of some kind.
It's my guess that some enemy power is preparing to build A-bombs right here in this country.
And then use them here?
I'm afraid that may be it. We must use every means we can to stop them.
For one thing, the authorities should check up on all the supplies and material and equipment of this country that might be used for atomic devices.
All such supplies are under strict government control already. But I'll ask the government authorities to recheck their security measures.
Let me know if you find anything suspicious.
I will, Larry.
Yes, Ross has already removed the uranium from the mine. All you have to do is to meet him with the plane at the usual place.
Are you sure you can trust Ross and the men with the plane? I don't like letting strangers in on our projects.
They don't know anything about your plan to blast Earth out of its orbit so Mars can take its place. They just think they're furnishing me with uranium for my own private use, as they've done before.
Very well.
All right, Mr. Steele, we'll leave right now. It looks like the security controls aren't as tight as Mr. Steele thought they were. The Kingpin mine reports a shipment of high-grade uranium ore stolen.
Stolen from the mine?
Yes, apparently it was loaded onto pack horses and taken out across the desert. They tried to follow the tracks, but they lost it in rocky grounds.
So we gotta make like a couple of Indians in trailer. Do I have to ride a horse?
No, but you may have to do some scrambling around on foot.
Down this road. I'll fly over those hills to the west. We'll keep in touch by radio.
Right.
Boys, there they are. Thank you.
Bob.
Come in, Bob.
Come in, Larry.
I've spotted them. They're loading the stuff into a plane on a dry lake about a mile west of where you are now. Drive cross country until I meet you.
Right.
They're just over the ridge, about a dozen of them.
That's a large order.
Yeah, we can't capture them all, so we'll try to drive off the riders and grab the plane. We'll get in as close as we can before we open up on them.
Right. I brought these along.
Good. Let's go. Let him have it.
Right.
Dr. Harding promised there'd be no interference.
Shut up, will you? You don't think this was our idea? Now, look, we're nearly loaded. I'll hold them off until you can get this thing out of here.
You'd better. All right, hurry it up.
Loaded. Take off.
Take off as fast as you can.
Hey, they're taking off. These will stop them.
That did it.
Yeah, and there won't be much fight left in that crew now.
Calling Sue. Calling Sue.
Yes, Larry, come in.
We recovered the uranium. They were transferring it from the pack horses to a plane. We disabled the plane and captured the two men in it, but the others escaped.
Do you have any idea who they were?
Yes. One of the prisoners talked. The leader was a mine foreman named Ross. I don't expect him to go back to the mine now, but he had an appointment to meet two payoff men there this afternoon. So I'm going to the mine and look for them. Is Mr. Steele still there?
Yes.
Ask him to phone the mine superintendent and arrange for me to get in. I'll take care of it right away.
He'll make all the arrangements. Good luck.
Ross is supposed to be working down the lower level. Must be a shaft somewhere ahead.
Hold it. I thought you fellows might show up here.
Thank you.
serious. We must have uranium for the construction of our H-bomb. Is there another source of supply?
I know where I can obtain some, but the cost would be very high. And since we've lost the money we paid to Ross, I'm afraid we can't afford it.
That isn't any problem. Many of your banks are loaded with cash.
They're loaded with guards, too.
Your part will be very minor and perfectly safe. On Mars, we long ago learned to use mechanical devices for difficult or dangerous work.
You mean you could build a machine to rob a bank?
That's what it amounts to. Only you would call it a robot. A mechanical man whose movements we can control from a panel here in this laboratory.
Do we have the necessary material here to build one?
We can buy the necessary electronic parts, and any sheet metal shop can construct the body for us. We will need...
All right, we'll be there. Thanks. Hey, Bob. It looks like Mr. Steele's campaign to alert anybody handling atomic supplies is paying off. That was a dealer in electronic equipment who reports a couple of strangers asking for some special tubes.
Did he give them to him?
Not yet. He said he'd have the stuff for them in an hour. That'll give us time to get down there and look them over.
Right on the minute. That's the store just ahead. We'll wait here.
There they are. Two old pals.
Right. And this is our chance to follow them to their headquarters.
You suppose that's their hideout?
Could be.
Like they're getting ready to load something in the car. Let's get behind it.
Hey, it looks like a robot. Hey, it's Martin.
Chance. He'll be gone before we can get to a car. At least we know they have a robot, which they're probably going to use for some kind of dirty work. We'll tell the authorities to be on the lookout for it. And if we can locate whoever operates it by remote control, we'll have the men we're looking for.
Calling M. Calling M.
Yes, Roth.
We're all set.
Very well. I'll take over from here.
Thank you. cops will be here in a minute. Hurry up.
Calling car 16. Calling car 16. Go to the Ferndale Bank. Alarm ringing.
Get going.
They're all right now.
I'll see if I can pick it up. That robot's in action already. They just used it to rob the Ferndale Bank.
So they're robbing banks, too?
Yes, and it's the same gang, all right. The police traced the getaway car through town, but they lost it somewhere in the Morongo Hills.
Why, that's where that rocket landed the first time.
Right. So there's a chance they might have headed for the same cave. I'm going to have a look.
Box is watertight?
Absolutely.
Our radio Marek's that you've arrived safely. You'd better wait to see if he has any further orders.
Okay.
Get your hands up.
Turn around.
Calling Marek's. Calling Marek's.
Come in, Narup.
Roth and Shane got here with the money, all right, but someone has just captured them in the outer cave.
Is the robot still there?
Yes.
Then I'll take over.
Get over by that wall.
On the box right behind him.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Thank you.
finish him.
There's an axe on the box right behind him.
Yeah, that'll do it. On the robot.
Calling Bob, calling Bob.
Come in, Larry.
The gang came to the cave, all right. They got away, but I've got the robot and the money must be here somewhere. Better come out and help me look for it.
You heard that?
Yes. You must stop him from finding that trap door.
They may have hidden in the shaft. There's sure nowhere else around here.
I'm going in to find out.
Not yet, it's pretty dark down there. I'll try again.
But it was too dark to see. We'll pick up a diving helmet, an underwater light, and try again.
We'll take the robot with us. When we examine it, we might find some clue to the remote control operator who's been working it.
I heard all that. We must protect that tunnel entrance at all costs. I'll come out and help you.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think we should construct our bomb in some other location?
No. That cave is at the exact point where my atomic explosion will be most effective in deflecting the Earth's rotation, forcing it out of its orbit so that my planet Mars can take its place.
But if Larry Martin investigates that underwater tunnel...
Don't worry about Larry Martin. We now have a sure method of eliminating him. The robot is in his laboratory. Tonight, you and Roth will break in there and repair it. Then stand by the controls. And the next time Martin enters his laboratory, send the robot into action.
Well, that should solve our problem.
Shane, you will take me out to the cave now. We must be on guard in case Martin returns there before you have a chance to get the robot working again.
Well, Everything seems to be in perfect working order. Larry Martin is due for a very unpleasant surprise tomorrow.
Yes, there's the diving helmet and the underwater light.
Seems all right.
You got plenty of oxygen?
I think so, but we'll take along an extra tank.
We were lucky that time, but I'm not taking any more chances. While Bob and I are out the cave, you take that thing apart in a lot of little pieces.
Right.
No use. I'll warn Marix. Calling Marix. Calling Marix.
I'm in, Harding.
The robot attack failed. Larry Martin disabled it.
That means Martin will be coming to search this cave at any time. Tell Roth and Shane to come out here immediately.
Yes, sir.
Do we have any explosives that can be detonated underwater?
Yes. Some of our small TNT bombs would do.
Then get one ready at once. We must set up a booby trap in the shaft.
Yes, sir. Let's rig this light.
Looks like that blast got Martin. Let's go.
What happened down there? Must have been a booby trap. I fell on something and everything went black. Well, did you find anything down there?
No. If there's any other entrance, it's too well hidden to find. I'm sure the money is not there. We'll try to get a map of this mine from the former owner. If it shows any workings back of here, we'll do more investigating.
Okay. But we probably scared them out of ever using this place again.
Calling Dr. Harding.
Calling Dr. Harding.
Come in, Max.
Larry Martin has escaped our trap, but he's left without discovering anything.
Then you still have the money?
Yes. So you can make your arrangements for purchasing the uranium at once. But in the meantime, we must have the other materials for the nuclear reactor brought in from the island base.
Do you think it's safe to try that again so soon?
Well, we must risk it.
We have to have the bomb completed by the time the Earth is at that point in its orbit from which it can be most easily deflected out into space.
Very well. Do you want me to arrange for the use of the submarine again?
Yes, but try to find a better method of bringing the cargo ashore this time. The material you'll be handling is radioactive enough to cause considerable electrical disturbance.
So get it into your lead safe as quickly as possible.
Yes, sir. Calling X-71. Calling X-71.
Trouble?
Not a bit. I just lured the nets and a diver from the submarine put the stuff in.
Is this all of it?
No, I'll get the rest tomorrow night.
Okay, help us get this stuff in the truck.
Just after 1 o'clock this morning, there was violent interference with all radio activity in this area. From the waterfront to the east side of town. It was undoubtedly caused by some highly radioactive material being moved through that area. This does not necessarily tie in with that gang you've been having trouble with, but it does indicate illegal traffic in some atomic material.
We know that gang's been working on some sort of atomic project.
Yes, and we know they've been trying to smuggle material into this country, so it adds up. I'll fly over the harbor area with a radioactivity detector and try to locate the source of that interference. Help me with the suit, Bob. Fine. Good luck, Larry. Thanks. Detector's in that drawer, Sue.
Anywhere near.
It's that submarine again.
That's my guess. So I want you to charter a speedboat, get an underwater detector, and some small depth charges.
Right.
I'll meet you here at the lab when you get back.
Everything's set for tonight. The gear will all be put in the boat by dark.
Good.
Can I go with you this time?
I'd rather have you patrol the waterfront area with a Geiger counter in case they get the stuff ashore before we locate it.
All right.
Let's go.
Shall I hook up the detector now?
I'll do it on the way out. Let's go.
about there. I picked up something. It's moving. Change course to 165.
165.
Submerged to 100 feet.
Aye, sir.
Reduced to quarter speed. We're right over it. Motor steady. What's she doing here?
She must have picked up that stuff on this Geiger counter. Take her up there and tie her up.
I'll make sure nobody else is around.
Out of sight.
What was that?
Let's take a look.
Hold it.
Search it. Thank you.
Some kind of an electronic device with radioactive material in it. It's plenty hot.
We're going to take it all apart and see if we can find any clue to the maker and what it's supposed to be used for.
You didn't find any trace of the rest of the cargo?
No, it's disappeared completely. But if they try to move it again, we'll be ready for them. I have men with Geiger counters planted on all the main highways. If anything radioactive is moved out of town, we'll pick it up.
That's a sensible plan. We know that gang are using atomic material, so you have a good chance of getting on the trail. Check with you later.
So, all the equipment is safe in my vault. Except, of course, the drum which was left on the dock.
Larry Martin is sure to have picked it up by now.
That is a very serious loss and will be difficult to replace. But in the meantime, we can go into the other phases on our project. Have you arranged to get a supply of uranium?
I've made arrangements for Roth to take the place of the guard on a truckload of uranium leaving the chemical warehouse this afternoon. He'll manage to have Shane with him.
Good. Once we get that uranium, we can go into the final stages on construction of the bomb.
Stay here. I'll signal you when it's clear.
Okay.
I'm your new guard. Sorry I didn't get here in time to check the load.
Well, it looks okay to me, but you can give it a quick count.
All right. You can go ahead and get your engine warmed up.
Stick up, pull over. Get out and start walking.
Get right after it. Our spotters picked up a radioactive truck heading east on Highway 40 just out of Kelso. Bob, take your car and get out on that highway.
Right.
Sue, you stay here. And both of you keep your radios open. I'll let you know if I need help.
Behind you.
Then catch up with us as soon as you can. I'm going to board the truck. I'll leave my radio open so you can both hear what happens.
Okay.
Right.
watch him close. I'll come back and help you.
What do we do with him?
Tie him up. And we'll go on till we get to a phone. We'll call the boss for orders.
Back there looks like he's tailing us. Take a look.
Okay. To get into his lab. Then we can grab that electronic gadget they got from us.
Good idea.
Did you hear that, Sue?
Yes.
There's a revolver in the second drawer of my desk. Can you use it?
Of course. I'll be ready.
Just walk right on in and don't make any breaks. There are two guns behind you. See, it's okay. Go on. Keep them covered. Here's what we want.
is him. Get that instrument. Let's go.
Larry, I thought they'd killed you.
Have they gone?
Yes.
The metal in my suit must have ground a part of the charge.
And they took that electronic device with them.
Is that the last of it?
That's it.
You take it and continue your work. I'm going to Dr. Harding.
Yes, sir.
Now we have everything we need to complete the H-bomb except the detonator, which is still on the island.
That's radioactive too, isn't it?
Of course. Why?
Well, it's obvious that Larry Martin has been tracing our recent shipments with radioactive detectors. By now, he undoubtedly has a screen which will be very difficult to penetrate.
Yes, you're right. It would be too risky to move it through town. We'll have to use the spaceship.
Well, that isn't safe either as long as Martin's rocket's in business.
Then we'll eliminate it.
That won't be easy. It's always guarded.
We can bomb it from our own rocket before it has time to take off. Can you secure some aerial bombs?
Yes, I have several experimental ones here. A new type, small but very powerful.
And our only problem is getting them to the rocket ship.
I've arranged for a foreign submarine to pick up one of my atomic power units in the east end of the bay tomorrow. I can have them take the bombs to your island base.
Good. You must create those bombs and haul them out of here at once. Then arrange for a boat for tomorrow.
Okay, but you ought to get rid of that truck. It's sure hot now.
Very well. Arrange to get another one. But take the old one away from here.
Okay. Go to town and pick up another truck. I'll meet you out in the canyon. We'll transfer the stuff and we'll leave the old truck there.
Right.
I've marked all the points where we picked up radioactivity readings on all the trucks. They all follow the same general route.
Yes, all the trails end up on the west side of town.
That's not much help. It'd take too long to search all the buildings in that area.
Sure, but that truck is easy to spot from the air. And if it's still anywhere around there, I'll pick it up.
You better wait till I catch up to you before you tackle them again.
I'm not going to try to capture them this time. I'm going to try to work it so they'll give me a lead to their headquarters. This is a portable radio transmitter, the kind they use on life rafts. It puts out a constant signal, one that can be picked up in a directional receiver anywhere within 100 miles. If I find that truck, I'll plant this transmitter on it. You stay here until I get back. Then we'll start using the small receiver.
Thank you.
Hey, there's Martin. It's one of these bombs.
Yeah, you're right.
Get the engine started. I'll keep him covered.
I was glad they ran for it. I'm just hoping they take that truck to the headquarters so we can nail the whole gang.
The direction signal's coming in strong. The truck's due west of here now.
Stand by your radio, Sue. We'll keep you posted. Let's go. Take the next turn right. Looks like we're heading for the waterfront.
Hey! What's this?
It's a radio signal transmitter. No wonder Martin let us get away so easy. He's tailing us. Take the truck and get going. Anywhere to lead him away from here. I'll handle the boat. Was almost at maximum, but it's fading now. They must have stopped for a while and started up again.
Could be.
We'll have to turn.
Hey! But... that looks like one of them now.
Another boat. Let's take it.
I just can't understand it. Why would anyone be taking bombs to a submarine?
I can't answer that. Up until now, they've only been interested in getting hold of material for some kind of atomic project.
Are you sure of that?
Reasonably so. Everything we've caught them with has been of atomic nature. Let's recap a bit. First, there was that shipment of uranium on the freight train. As you know, they captured the train.
Murray!
Isn't that Bob on top of that freight car?
Yes, when we got here, those men were stealing the train. Bob jumped on it and tried to stop them.
Any way to stop that train?
No, my key's out. They must have cut the wires after they slugged me.
There's the brake. Can you fix it?
I can fix it, but it'll take time.
Maybe I can catch them in a car.
Not much chance. The road only gets another tracks in a few places.
Is that old tank working?
Yes, we just unloaded it for some farmer who's going to make a tractor out of it.
Maybe I can cut across country and stop that train.
You better try. If it keeps going, you'll crash the through passenger train head on. Got this fixed.
About time we start and unload this stuff, isn't it? How'd that get on our trail?
I don't know, but they got on us somehow.
We're not gonna have much luck in loading a car of uranium with that thing chasing us.
Yeah, we better forget it. Make our getaway while we can. Train's already gone through the junction. Only one more chance now. If I can raise Gomez siding, they can derail the freight there.
Thank you.
apparatus, which could also be used for atomic work.
You mean that equipment they brought on the rocket?
Yes. They landed it in the mountains and brought it down the lake in boats. I located their dock.
Hey! Somebody's snooping around our stuff.
Evidence points to some illegal atomic project, but we still...
Larry Martin's office. For you, Mr. Steele.
Yes? Very well, I'll be right over. Some officials from Washington are waiting for me in my office. We'll continue this discussion at a later time.
All right. In the meantime, we'll keep trying to find out what they're doing.
Fine. Goodbye.
Larry Martin is sure to intercept our rocket if we try to bring it in.
But we must. We have to get that detonator from the island to complete our hydrogen bomb. Martin's rocket must be destroyed.
That'll be a tough job. It's well guarded.
That ray gun you developed, would one of its shells penetrate the hull of Martin's rocket?
Yes, it would go through the hull and burst inside.
And that's our answer. When Martin takes off to intercept our rocket, he will have to fly over Eagle Peak. You and Shane set the gas gun up there. Blast him when he comes over.
Okay. When will your rocket be coming through?
As soon as you get the cannon set up, I'll radio them to start.
Okay.
That mysterious rocket is headed this way again. I've ordered Dick to take off my ship and I'll fly aboard it.
Be careful.
Thank you.
are you doing, Dick?
Well, everything's fine. What's the course? Hold her as she goes. I'll see if I can pick up something in radar.
Right. How are you doing, Dick?
Well, everything's fine.
Let him have it.
What's that?
It's fireball. Or gas.
What hit us?
It was a gas shell. But we'll be all right if we keep these helmets on until it clears out.
Here it comes.
Martin, come in.
The unidentified aircraft has gone off our radar screen.
Did it land?
We can't tell. It was a long way out when it disappeared.
All right. We'll return to base. That's it, Dick. Let's head back.
Right.
Here's the detonator. Hila said he'd stay in the rocket.
Is the rocket well hidden?
Yes, we covered it with branches. Nobody can spot it from the air.
Good. Nothing can stop us now. It'll only take a few hours to attach this detonator. Then we can all take off for Mars.
Are you sure the rocket can carry all of us and your men from the island, too?
Oh, yes. Now get Dr. Harding. He's going to help me make the final adjustments on the bomb.
Okay.
Putting out a strong transmission wave.
But that means it's televising a picture of this room right to its control board.
Which is exactly what we want. My indicator will keep me on the beam, and I'll fly right along it to the gang's headquarters.
And if they have their receivers on, they'll be waiting for you with a warm welcome.
That's a chance we'll have to take. Stand by the radio. I'll keep you posted.
Dr. Harding's house.
What? You mean Dr. Harding is one of that gang?
It looks like it. The robot control panel is certainly in his house. But it'll take some strong evidence to convict a man like Dr. Harding.
Finding the control panel in his house ought to be enough.
Not unless we prove his panel actually controls the robot. So load that robot in the car and bring it out here as fast as you can.
I'm going inside now, but I'll keep my radio open so that you'll know what's going on.
Right. Be ready in a minute.
What are these men doing here, Dr. Harding?
They're trying to steal some of my designs. They forced me to put them in this briefcase.
Turn around. Stay where you are. I came to investigate your robot control panel, Dr. Harding.
Good work, Doc.
Get up. Do you have any diving gear?
You'll need it going through that water tunnel.
Yes, in that cabinet. There are two of them there.
They knocked me out. Did you hear anything after that?
Yes, just before they left, they were talking about taking some diving gear to go through the underwater tunnel.
Then there is a tunnel out of that shaft in the cave.
There must be. We'd better get out there.
Wait a minute. You've got the robot in the car. We've got the control panel here. We'll take it along and let the robot do the fighting for us.
Swell.
Hey, we'll take that diving gear, too.
Just before you get to the cave, and we'll set up the control panel.
Right.
Better stand guard outside until we finish.
Okay.
All set? Here he goes.
Got him on the run.
That. We'll leave the robot there and try that underwater tunnel. Let's get the diving gear.
Larry Martin.
Take care of him.
Thank you.
completed. The bomb will explode in 2 hours. By that time, we'll be well on our way to Mars.
What did you run into down there?
There's a shaft in the back end of that tunnel. Somebody came down and cut the air hose. They must have a hideout in there.
What can we do about it?
We can keep them in there until we get help.
Go out to the car and radio Mr. Steele to send some troops with underwater gear.
We're trapped. No, we're not. Where are those gas bombs?
They're right over there, sir.
Get them. We'll saturate that cave with gas. It won't hurt us, and this diving gear will protect you.
No, no, we can't risk it. We might be delayed too long.
We have no other choice.
We do. We can shut off that bomb and give ourselves up.
Do you think I'm going to abandon our whole project just when we're on the verge of success?
My life means more to me than your project. I'll shut off that bomb myself.
Another hour before they get here.
Well, all we can do is wait.
Maybe we can catch him.
I'd better fly after them.
Take off at once.
Yes, sir.
Just took off from the mountains back of Lake Emerald. Tell Dick to take off with my rocket at once. I'll board it in the air.
Right. Calling the rocket. Larry Martin's rocket.
Hey,
Where do we go now?
Just hold her as she goes until I pick up that rocket on radar.
Right.
There he is. Firing ray gun. That did it. He's going down.
Swell. We following?
That's rough country to land in. I'll fly down. You take the ship back to the field.
Yes, sir.
How about the others?
I think they're all dead.
You're in pretty bad shape yourself. Take it easy and I'll call for an ambulance.
No. First you must stop the bomb.
What bomb?
In the back cave. Through the water tunnel. It'll blow up soon. Destroy the whole world.
How can I get in there?
Turn the rock knob on the left wall. Just ahead of the trap door. Hurry!
Has a fair chance of recovery, but he's still too weak to talk.
Then we'll have to wait before we find out what this is all about.
Not entirely. The papers we found in Harding's laboratory explain why they're building the hydrogen bomb. Its explosion was intended to deflect the rotation of the Earth enough to send it out of its orbit and spinning off into space.
Those zombies must have been as crazy as they looked.
It may sound ridiculous, but it's theoretically possible.
It's certainly lucky you managed to stop them in time.
Yeah, we're safe now.
For the time being. But there are undoubtedly more of those power-mad creatures loose on other planets. So it'll take constant vigilance on our part to ensure the safety of this world.